Every other kid I know lived a normal life. They enjoyed the innocence of childhood and the sports that goes with it. But for me, it was a little different. In my mother's words, I was born under a mysterious circumstance. But in my father's eyes, everything was always just fine. My name is Max. Max Okonkwo. And here is my story.
Max, what's the matter? Why are you not dressed for school?
You shouldn't go anywhere today, Mom. Bad things will happen.
God forbid.
What are you saying? Have you been dreaming again?
No, Mom. It's never a dream. It's always been real, and this time it's going to be really bad.
I reject it in Jesus' name. Max! Look, you need to stop all these pranks. You're scaring your parents.
Oh, sweetheart. Let him be. Come, come, my boy, come. See, whatever it is you saw was only a dream, okay? So you don't have anything to worry about. So hurry up, go get dressed. Let's go. We're running late, okay?
Good boy.
How are you feeling? Any major pain?
Doctor, where is my husband?
Your husband?
Where is my son? Doctor, please speak. Where is my son? Where is my husband? I need to see them.
I'm sorry. You didn't make it.
How was the library?
The same way it always is. Quiet.
Yeah.
Good for reading.
I can imagine.
And you look so tired, like you have read.
Yeah, I am tired. Very tired.
Oh, Allah. Bubu, take a look, take a look. Is she not blazing hot?
Which of them?
Peggy now, the one on red. Don't tell me you don't know her. The only girl on this campus with balls.
Why, please?
Do you know, I even heard she turned down Paul's proposal. Paul of all bad guys.
Oh, really?
I swear, he's just going to make her life miserable on this campus.
Well, it's not my business. But on a serious note, Paul needs to leave this campus alone. I mean, he's gathered there for several years now. I don't know.
Leave this campus, you say? To where? You should know that this is something grand. Hey, bro, what's up now? So leaving this campus, where is he going to be getting all his pretty babes from?
Well,
so
anyways, it's none of my business.
Oh yeah,
none of my business. I need to leave now.
Oh, I know wahala
now. Getting late.
No wahala now.
Let me
cheers.
Check some.
Catch you up later, in the evening.
See ya.
Of everything that happens and everything.
You ladies are too beautiful to be walking on the street, and it's too hot for that. Please, please allow me. Let me give you a ride.
No, thank you. We're doing just fine. Besides, our lecture hall is right around the corner.
I'm just trying to be your friend. Besides, a queen like you shouldn't be walking. Allow me. Let me please give you a ride.
Look, like I said earlier, we are doing just fine. Please, I would really appreciate it if you can just leave us alone. Thank you.
Hi. Not to worry. I'll talk to her. I think she's in a bad mood.
Julie, wait, hold on, wait. What was that all about earlier?
What?
What were you doing interfering?
Oh, that. Come on, Peggy. That guy looks nice and he has money. He has money too. I just thought you should at least give him a little attention. A little attention. It's not too much to ask.
Really?
Yes, really.
So that's how it is now?
Oh, please.
Look, Julie, look, I don't like it at all. I don't like what you did at all. And please, you should not repeat itself again. I don't like
okay, it. Okay, sorry. Sorry now.
Please leave me. No, I'm really upset. No, I'm. Hey. It's you again. Are you okay?
Yes, yes, I'm fine, I'm fine.
Then why are you holding your head like that?
I'd like to let you know that Paul is going to call you in 1 minute.
Wait, hold on, wait. How do you know about this? So that jobless boy has sent you after me, right?
No one has sent me after you.
Look, please, you guys should get busy and leave me alone. Tell Paul to leave me alone. Look, I am here to study and focus on that, please. Hello?
Hello, Peggy, this is Paul.
Hey, where are you off to? Wait. Hold on, wait. Who are you? Look, I'm going to call the security if you do not tell me who you are. What is your name?
My name is Max. I'm a final year student working to graduate this year, that's all.
Look, that cannot be all, okay? It cannot be all. Look, you need to tell me what I need to know.
Please, can we discuss this tomorrow? I'm running late for my lecture.
Listen, you're not going anywhere until you tell me all I need to know. And besides, why do I need to see you tomorrow? Hey, listen, I'm serious about calling the security on you. If you do not tell me what I need to know.
Please, I'm serious. I'm running late for my lectures. Let's meet tomorrow. I promise to answer all your questions. I'm for the records. I don't work for Paul. I don't.
Truly, something strange happens today.
What happened? Now talk to me. Did you meet that nice guy or that sweet fair guy? Oh, you know I love them fair.
What guy are you talking about?
That one, now that fair one, the one with the nice guy that we met yesterday.
No, not exactly. But I met this strange guy. He said his name is Max.
Then what happened?
It was quite a strange encounter. Okay, I recall seeing him some days back, and then I saw him again today. And then he held his head with his hands like he had a headache or something. And then he looked at me and told me...
Go on, told you what?
You know what? Never mind, Julie. Look, I think it's just some drunk guy speaking rubbish. Look, babe, I'm tired. I need to take a nap.
Babe, I've been dropping drugs half. Don't raise it up.
You too, like, Jesus.
Babe, don't raise it up. Do not tell me everything. I'm able.
Max, are you okay? What's wrong? Max, what's wrong?
Peggy, we need to leave here now. Something bad is about to happen, and I didn't get a clue on time.
What are you talking about? What clue? What's going on? What is it?
We need to leave. Pack your things, let's go.
What is it?
Peggy, take this way. We couldn't get him. He vanished. 1 minute he was in front of us, and the next minute he was gone.
But he was running. Running and touching his head like someone who had something to remember. Exactly. Like someone who had a map in his head trying to remember something.
I knew there was something about that boy.
I'm not the thief. I'm not the thief. I'm just sorry for my dear life.
The both of you are fools. Big fools. I sent you to go get me a mummy's boy. And here the both of you are standing here, ranting, like I sent you to wrestle a bull.
So bad guys are after me. Yes, sir.
Get the hell out of my face. I said get out!
Young man, who is after you?
There's some two strange looking faces. I don't even...
Shut up! Shut your mouth, you young boys. Instead of concentrating on your studies, you are wasting your parents' money. Shut your dirty stinking trap there. Thank God I don't have family. I would have smoked them all. Idiots. Nonsensical. Young man, who are you? Where did you get this mark from, young man?
It's a birthmark. I was born with it.
You were born with it. You were born with the mark of the bearer. Impressive.
I don't understand what you're saying, sir.
Do you know how many years I've toiled on this earth?
I have answered as much as I was told. I don't understand what you're saying, sir.
So, what did your father tell you about it? Did he say it's a tattoo from your forefathers? Oh, no, no, no. Better still. Did he say you are a reincarnation of your great-grandfather?
My father is late. I lost him when I was 9 to an accident. An accident I saw before it happened, but could not stop because they would not listen to me.
I see.
I saw it happen in my head before it really did. But I warned them, but they dismissed me. They said I was dreaming.
I still cannot believe I'm looking at the bearer of the curse of Ikago.
I don't understand what curse of Ikago.
Did your parents tell you about it?
I've never heard anything about any curse, and nobody has ever told me anything about that.
Is your mother alive?
Yes, she is alive. And I need to call her. I need to speak to her. This doesn't make any sense.
Go on, talk to her. There is a lot yet untold about you. You are not a mere child, Max. You are not.
Max, my son, you don't know how excited I am to have you here. You don't know how tough it has been to live in this whole house all alone.
Mom, I can imagine. I had to come back urgently to discuss something with you.
What? You said so when you called. I hope there's no problem.
No, not really. I just need you to tell me what you know about the mark on my chest.
The mark on your chest.
Mm-hmm.
The mark on your chest.
Yes.
Why are you anxious? What is the matter?
Not serious, but I still need you to answer the question.
Oh, Max, why all these questions? Why? Is anything a problem? Are you in any problem? Just talk to me. I'm your mom. I can't talk about it.
Mom, there's this figurine I used to see in that shelf. Please, can you tell me how it came to be?
How does it matter to you suddenly? That figurine has been in your father's shelf for many years.
I know, Mom, but I believe there's something different about that piece. I mean, the way Dad almost worshipped it.
Max.
Yes, ma'am.
You know, it has been I and I alone trying to do my best to take care of you and make you happy. You know that. Mm-hmm. Why do you want to bring out this? Why do you want to bring up this subject that is sad to me? Why?
Oh, I'm really sorry. I'm really sorry. I don't mean to open up old wounds with these questions. But I want to be told these things. I'm not a boy anymore, Mom. I want to be told about our history. I need to know these things, please, Mom.
I waited so many years to see today. The story around that figurine is a mystery to me. It is a secret your father kept till his death. That was the most painful aspect of his death. The untold story of the figurine.
Mom, I'm really sorry. I sincerely am. But please, I need you to tell me. I need to know. Please, Mom. Please.
Max, my son. You know I loved your father so much. I loved him for so many reasons. Especially his uniqueness and his love for art. You know that.
Yeah. My darling, how are you? I got this. A lovely piece by the great painter Fred Amadi. You know, he's an experimentalist at the core. You love it?
Yeah, it looks great to me. And you know I love to see you in this mood, right?
You know I love paintings. So...
Thank you.
So, what's my beautiful wife making for lunch?
Something delicious.
You serious?
Yes.
Can I go check it out?
Okay, you come with me.
All right. Oh, I love this painting. My love, how are you?
I'm fine. Honey, I wonder what you're sneaking up to our room.
Oh, these. Take a look. This is one of my diamonds from the Treasure Island.
I do not know what you're talking about, but this does not look like a diamond to me. I wonder why you're treating this special among others.
Well, I am because it's actually a god to many. And as a matter of fact, a priceless plus to my collections.
God?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Where did you get it from?
I got it from one of those black market traders. You see, they actually warned me about the potential powers of this, so I'm curious to see it manifest.
So happy I got this, man. I missed you too.
But you need to be really careful about this. They might be stolen, you know.
Don't worry, this one is not stolen, and I can promise you I will never get us into any problems, okay?
Up.
Man, I'm so happy I got this. It's been a long time coming.
This is Image 95.5 FM. Newsflash. It has been reported that some armed men burgled and took away some religious artifacts from the Eji Shrine in Oluwago Town, including the famous Ikaru figurine. News indeed.
Honey, is anything the matter?
Yes. Everything is fine. How are you, my darling?
Fine, are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure.
Since then, I knew there was something strange, something wrong about that figurine. But he insisted. He insisted there was nothing wrong till his death. We fought over it severally. Even when you were born with a mark, he insisted there was nothing wrong.
Thank you, Mom. I'm glad you told me all this.
Thanks, son.
I'll be going back to school very soon.
But hold on. Why all this? Why all the questions? Please, are you in any trouble? Is anything wrong?
No,
please talk to me.
It's nothing. I'm fine.
Are you sure?
I'm fine. I'm just happy to know this. I feel enlightened. Okay, everything is fine.
All right.
I'm amazed. My mom doesn't know for sure, but there is definitely something mysterious about the mark on my chest.
Certainly, son. Certainly.
There is this figurine I used to see in my dad's shelf. It's very similar to the mark I have on my chest.
Amazing. It has a lion head on an abstract body and is resting on a box.
Yes, sir.
Interesting.
All my mom knows about it is that he got it from some unknown black market traders 24 years ago.
Calm down. Don't worry, I will tell you a story.
And it happened over 24 years ago.
Hey, tell Abani, we have his guts here. He can try, but he will never get it back.
The anger of Ikeagu rain heavily on you and your family.
You're talking about anger. So many gods are already angry with me. So yours will never make any difference. Let's go.
Who did this to you?
Some armed men. They took away everything. I could not stop them. I wonder why the gods of Eji did not strike them instantly. They took away the cargo.
Ah! They have beaten a piece of meat
that would be so difficult for them to chew. Now they will know the untold sorrows and glories of Echi. Within the resting place of Ikago shall the Biara sprout, a Biara of wisdom and of tall stories and curse.
That was how we lost Ikago. And I was relieved of my office as peacemaker in the shrine. And I was told never to return. I learned to burn, committed suicide, and the shrine was burnt down by a mysterious thunderbolt. Max. Max!
So, where do I go from here?
You need to call it out and live with it.
You master your curse!
But how do I master this sort of life? I don't even know what it is. Why me?
We do not have a control over our past. But we can put in some effort in the present to shape the future.
But that is when you have a normal life. See what is upon me. How do I master this sort of life?
I will help you.
What interesting thing do you bring this time?
A clever boy was spotted on the streets of campus. Just your type. Smart, smooth, with a bit of mystery.
So, where is the boy?
Well, he's still on the streets. He's not like the other groceries. I would have bagged him by now.
I see. Your boys have failed. Your good-for-nothing boys, they keep chasing shadows.
Not really. They were...
Paul, you ought to know by now that though the chick may be small, it's big enough to get the mother into a fight. Touch the chick and the mother will come. Go get me the chick. And let the mother bring forth the battle. Go with Bello, he won't fail.
Yes, Dad.
Thank you. take a deep breath. Concentrate on your pains.
The bad guys were after me. They have gone to kidnap her. I have to help her. I have to help her.
Max, wait!
My name is Max.
Max? She has mentioned that name severally. Unfortunately, she...
Hello?
Fresh fish. Max guys, come on. We have your kids. And if you're truly the mother hen, meet us today at Amazon. Come here.
Talk to us now, what's happening? Like, come, Mr. Max.
What is this? Bello, how many times will I teach you to be kind and polite to my guests? Are you insane?
Untie him immediately.
Find a whistle.
Leave us. Leave us. I am so sorry, Max.
So sorry. You see, that is the problem with young people. They do not understand simple instructions and they will not ask questions. I simply requested that they should invite Max for a chat. What did they do? They accosted you with bazookas and ammo tanks. Please accept my apologies. What can I offer you?
Please, sir. Who are you? And what do you want from I am Peggy?
I have tea and coffee. I have whiskey. I have red wine.
Oh, God!
Oh, I see. You are truly the bearer of the mark. Amazing. The seer was right.
Seer? What seer? What do you know about my birthmark?
My dear friend, please pardon my rudeness and permit me to introduce myself formally. I am Chief Dr. Fred Igwe. And I like partnering with young talents to grow my business and at the same time give them the opportunity to have a good life. We have a lot to give each other. We have a lot to benefit from each other. But before I proceed, just a minute. Just 1 minute.
Bello? Let the young lady go already and make sure she is safe. Am I clear, you mannerless being? Good. Max, I know what you can do. I know because I'm a very proactive man. You need to be proactive to survive and make it into this tough and competitive business world.
Open up! Julie!
My God, Peggy! What happened? Hope you're not hurt. Talk to me now, Peggy, what happened? Look,
it's quite strange. They just locked me up in a room since morning. And then this night they dropped me off. I don't know what exactly they wanted, but I am sure it's in connection to Max.
Max?
Yes, Max. I'm just tired of this whole thing.
Just come sit down.
Oh, God.
Sir, you told me where we're going to.
Oh, don't worry, Max. We are simply going to pay your mom a visit.
Mom?
Yes.
Please, sir. Leave my mom out of this. She has been through a lot in her life. I don't want to bring her more troubles.
Max, stop panicking. We are simply going to pay your mother a courtesy visit. We're just going to let her know that her son now works for Chief Dr. Fred Igwe.
Why do you need me dead? Why have you ordered people to kill me?
My goodness. My goodness. This is amazing. This is simply amazing. Max, you are a genius.
Hold on. Oh my God.
Hello? Bello. Abort the mission right now. We found ourselves a treasure. Abort the mission. Max, welcome to your new home. Welcome. Max. As discussed, we are setting out for the mission tonight. And you know you're a key player.
Sir, I'm not clear on what you want me to do. I'm not even sure about the objective of this so-called mission.
We all have a part to play. You don't have to do anything about the mission. Just leave it to the rest of us. I just need you to be an extra eye. Someone who gives us extra information that can keep us all alive. Right?
That's right. I mean, you have the ability to spot danger from kilometers away. So all you have to do is alert us once we get into any danger zone. That's it?
No, sir. No. I can't do this. I'm not sure about what this mission is. And I'm not prepared to risk my life just to join in a God knows what mission. No, I can't.
Max, I know where your mother lives on Fredson Street. I know Peggy's lounge. I know where her parents live. I even know where your father was buried in Bury. Yet you have the animal effrontery to say no to me? Are you insane? Are you insane?
Word of advice, Max. No one says no to Chief Red. The last time anyone did, their heads rolled off their body. So I suggest you reconsider if you want to go home the same.
Max, open, open.
Max, where have you been? I've been looking all over for you.
Shh, we need to leave here now. Where's your roommate?
She's not here. Look, look, Max, listen. I am not hanging out with you again. Because the last time I did, I got kidnapped.
Shh, speak quietly. Trust me, if you don't live with me now, you're going to get kidnapped again.
What? Kidnapped again?
Yes, and I don't want that to happen.
Okay, look, Max, listen, listen. I am not going to anywhere with you, okay? Listen, my life was so simple and then you and Paul showed up and boom.
There is no time for this now. We need to leave immediately.
Max, God.
Who is after you again? Where have you been?
I went for Peggy. It wasn't a good experience at all. They kidnapped her to get my attention and they succeeded. They took me to one Chief Fred.
Chief Fred? Liquid matter. Oh my God. This should not have happened.
You know him?
Everybody knows Liquid Metal. He's a top dog drug dealer that disguises himself as the distributor of expensive wine.
Okay, sir. I am glad you know him. I am in a very big trouble right now. I need your help to get out of it.
Let me guess. He wants you to work for him.
Exactly. How did you know?
What else would he need you for? You are a live weapon yet to be detonated. You are the perfect sixth eye for anyone like Liquid Metal. If only you have told me that day when you dashed away, we would have looked for a better way.
Sir, please. I'm in a very big trouble, sir. I need your help, please.
There's nothing we can do at this point. It's either you're on the run or you kill Liquid Metal. It's easier to run, though.
What if we call the police?
Police? Police! You better have a very solid evidence against him before you call the police. His boys are everywhere.
Are you prepared? We leave in 2 hours.
Yes, I am, but I need to speak to Chief first before we leave.
Oh, that's cool. Knock at his door.
Okay.
All right.
Come in.
Hello, Max.
Hello, sir.
I actually love brave young men. It takes a lot of guts to work with you. I agree. You know, only the brave survive and get rich. The chicken hearts live their lives scrambling for the crumbs. Bigger still, takes a very impressive amount of courage to think about killing Jafred, even in his own house. Come on, Max. Where are you going? We've not even started talking. Take a seat.
Max, we leave in 10 minutes. Meet us at the garage.
Oh, that's simple. He's a good client. He's very well connected. And besides, you never run away from money. You're protected. Oh, I see. Which brings me to the reason why you are here. See, you can detect danger, right? So we're just a few kilometers out.
Paul, but you know it doesn't work that way. He comes to me like a vision.
How, Paul? Why are we wasting our time on this little boy? We built so much hope on him and he's still messing up.
Bello, drive this car.
Drive to where? We choose to work with something that is not visible.
You are beginning to get on my nerves. I am trying to be patient and you know what I am capable of. Drive this car!
We have to stick to plan B. No time.
Get out the car.
Why?
Get your ass out the car. I am not working with you on this anymore. Get out!
You must be joking. I don't work for you. I work for your father. We are both partners on this mission. You should get that.
See, the man with the gun says, get your ass out the car. Now!
And what? Poor what?
You messed up. You messed up. You messed up. Now go.
You will regret this.
Bello. Bello.
Bello.
No, Bello. Bello.
Ah. Double High Chief Mark Eto. The only man that feasts with the gods. I greet you, Chief. Are you serious? It can't be. No. Chief, I don't believe this. My best men along with my only son were sent to deliver this to you. It's impossible. We are already 30 minutes behind schedule. What? It's not possible. Stone.
Sir.
You people will have to move their bodies to the car and take them to the house.
Okay, sir.
I have just been beaten by a chick that has teeth.
It's a pity, sir.
I'll have to smoke him and feed his own meat to the dogs.
You're under arrest. Put your hands where we can see them.
Hands up.
Sky!
Sky! Sky! Sky! Sky! Sky!
Dear Max, I couldn't take being useless at such a crucial time again. Once I lost Dekar to common thieves, now I lose you to a terrible chief. I can't live with it. See you in the afterlife.
No, Sky.
Sky.
Peggy, are you there? It's Max. Peggy! Hello, Peg!
Please, what is the problem now? Eh? You were banging on the door so hard like you owned the door.
I'm sorry for disturbing you. Please, is Peggy around? I know she should have come back the same day I was here.
She traveled 2 days after the shocking experience she had. I'm equally traveling now because I'm scared, like very, very scared. Oh. Okay. Did you call her number?
Oh, that's true. Let me try. Her number is not reachable.
Okay then, it could be network. Just keep calling. Just try again.
All right, thank you. Please, what's your name?
Julie. Okay. My name is Julie. Right. It's a pleasure.
Pleasure is mine. Nice. Thank you, and safe journey where you're traveling.
All right,
Max, yeah, it's me, Peggy.
Oh, Peggy, is that you? Oh my goodness, you're fine, right? Where have you been?
Yeah, I'm fine. I came to spend some time with my parents. Where have you been? I've been trying to call you, but your line is not reachable. I'm worried.
It's a long story, Peggy. As a matter of fact, I'm just coming from your apartment. How have you been, and how is lecture?
Well, I've been okay. Lectures are going good. What about your lectures?
You know now, engineering unit.
Brain boxers.
Yeah, you can say that again. But we're getting along fine. Hopefully, we'll graduate in the next few months. And
okay.
The phone is ringing. Who is this now?
Just check it.
Oh, my mom. Hello, Mom. How are you doing?
I'm fine, my son. And you, how are you doing? High school.
School is fine. But you're sounding cold. What's the matter?
Something strange has been happening in the house. I kept it to myself. I didn't want to bother you.
Why? You should have called me. What's the matter?
You know your father's room has been locked for years. I don't go there. I kept his things the way they are since he died 14 years ago.
Mm-hmm. So what happened?
Lately, I started hearing strange noise, strange sounds, like things falling, footsteps, and so on. Son, I am so terrified.
Mom, you should have called me. That is very strange. What do we do now?
I don't know. I don't know, please. You just have to come and check your dad's room. Please, I'm scared.
Remain calm. You'll see me this evening, I promise. Okay?
Okay, okay. Thank you, sir. I'll be expecting you, okay?
All right, Mom. Just remain calm. Bye.
Hey, what's up? Is everything okay with your mom?
Yes, everything is okay, but something strange is happening back at home. I need to go home this evening to see my mom.
Oh, sorry. I guess we will see later then, right?
Yeah, we'll see later.
All right. Okay. Let's just go.